Hello, good morning children. Today we are going to see remaining part of the chapter Disaster Management. In case of disaster management, we are going to see remedial and preventive measures. Let us see what precaution we can take before or in the event of a natural or man-made disaster. Keep watching TV and radio news and bulletins. Use battery-operated radios and mobiles. Heed the warnings issued by the meteorological department carefully. Heed means we have to carefully attend the warnings that will be given by the meteorological department. Now, regarding this disaster, either man-made or natural disaster, we will get information from the website www.imd.gov.in. Landslides occur in hilly areas due to a cloudburst or heavy rains. On such occasions, do not take shelter at the foot of a hill. At the foot of a hill means what, children? Means near the base of a hill. During floods, do not linger in houses or areas on river banks. Linger means we cannot spend more time in case of flood near to the river banks or in case of near to that river banks houses. Seek shelter in other safe places. Seek means we have to search the shelter, or we can take anyone's help for safe place. Move to safer places at great height. Do not step into the water currents or drive a vehicle into them. So whenever flood is there, so more amount of water is on the earth, so we cannot drive vehicle also in that situation. Now, in case of earthquake, suppose earthquake is there, then that time road split open, the ground cracks, railway tracks uprooted. Uprooted means these roads and these railway tracks, they are going inside the soil. Hence, when moving from one place to another, ensure that the road is further on. Means whenever we are moving from one place to another place or safe place, that time we have to take care that this road should be safe or railway track should be safe. Take shelter in relief camps as they provide medicines, food packets, drinking water, first aid, etc. So when we are stuck in any disaster, either man-made or natural, so that time some relief camps are available, so they are providing essential things, then we can take those essential things also. To get protection from fire, use fire extinguishers in public places like school, hospitals, railway stations, etc. Suppose anywhere you went, in school, hospital or railway station, and that time you stuck in the fire, then that time fire extinguishers are available. Fire extinguishers means what? In case of schools, hospitals or railway station, red color cylinders you are looking, children. That red color cylinders are called as fire extinguishers. So with the help of that fire extinguishers, you can put off the fire. Now, first aid. What is the meaning of first aid? Immediate aid, even before the medical aid arrives, is known as first aid. Means, before going in hospital or taking any medical help, whatever precaution we are taking, that is called as a first aid. Immediate aid, before medical help, that is called as a first aid. This is extremely essential during disasters or accidents, as it can help to save somebody's life. So, in case of any disaster or any accident, first aid is very, very important. Now, which are the types of first aid? First is external bleeding. So, which precaution you have to take when external bleeding you are looking or you got any external bleeding? Make the injured person sit or lie down. If any person is there, injured person, you have to tell that person sit comfortably or lie down. Clean the wound with the clean water. You have to clean that external part of that bleeding with clean water. Keep the injured part above the level of the hurt. And that injured part should be above the level of the hurt. Now, second first aid is burns or scalds. Now, in case of burns, there are two types of burns. That is minor burn and second is major burn, or we can tell it as serious burn also. Now, when minor burn is there, which precaution we can take? That we will see. The burn part should be washed with cold water or held under the running water. So, if any burning part is there, that on that part we have to apply cold water, or on the running water you can put your hand. Victim should be given water to drink. Victim means any patient is there, those who got that minor burn. To that patient we have to give water. Cotton swab soaked in antiseptic solution should be used to clean the wound. So, cotton swab you have to take and that you have to soak in case of antiseptic solution. And after soaking that, we have to clean that wound with the help of that cotton swab. Oily ointment should not be applied. Any oil cream is there or oily creams are there, then that we cannot put on that minor burn. Dry dressing should be used to cover the wounds. So, if possible, you can do dry dressings also. Now, second type is serious burns. In case of serious burn, you have to cover the wound with sterilized cloth. Sterilized means that should not be infected or that should be cleaned. Jewelry, shoes and tight cloth should be removed. So, if near to burning part, if any jewelry is there or shoes are there or tight clothes are there, that you have to remove. Oily ointment should not be applied. Cloths may be stuck to victim's body. Do not pull them. Sometimes what happens, children, if any serious burn is there or major burn is there, so that time, if suppose near to hand any serious burn is there, so if serious burn is there, then you are going to remove that cloth or that clothes, then due to that also there is a chances of spreading the burn. So do not pull that cloth stuck near to the victim's body, means any patient's body. Conscious victim should be given water to drink, but other stimulating drinks like tea or coffee should not be given. Conscious means sometimes any serious burn is there, and due to that serious burn, that patient becomes unconscious. But suppose patient is conscious, then that time we can give him or her water to drink, but no need to give tea or coffee. Try to get medical aid as soon as possible. After doing this first aid, if that burn is very serious, then you have to go in hospital for any medical precaution or medical help. Give emotional support to the victim. And emotional support is very, very important in case of serious burn. Now, third type of the remedial measure is sunstroke. If a person works continuously for a long time in the sun, then the body loses water and minerals, and these dehydration results in sunstroke. Dehydration means removal of water, or excess amount of water is removed from our body in the form of sweat. That is called as a dehydration. And due to this dehydration, there is a formation of sunstroke. Now, remedial measures for sunstroke. The patient should be immediately taken to a cool place or in the shade. So we have to take that patient in case of any cold place or in the shade. The body should be given cold sponge bath. So we have to give that full body of the patient cold sponge bath, or we have to wipe that body with the help of cold sponge. The neck of a patient should be covered with a wet cloth, and we have to cover the neck of the patient with the help of wet cloth. Patient should be given water or sharbat to drink in order to stop the dehydration. And if possible, we can provide water or sharbat to that patient for removal of dehydration. Patient should be made to lie in prone position, that is on his or her abdomen with the head turned to one side. So that patient should be lie in case of abdomen with the head turned on one side, means that head should be look one side only. Like that we can prone that patient. In case of seriousness of sunstroke, ship the patient to the hospital or get medical help. And if that patient is serious, then we have to ship that patient in the hospital, or we can take any medical help. Now, fourth type of remedial measure is snake bite. All snakes are not poisonous. Only few, such as cobras, crates, bivipers and sea snakes, are poisonous. Bite poisonous snake is fatal, means it causes death also. But bite by non-poisonous snakes can also cause psychological shock, resulting in the death. Sometimes if any snake is biting, but if that snake is non-poisonous, but due to psychological shock, means some are thinking that I got bite by snake, and due to that also it causes death. Instead of killing, one should try to save the snake with the help of volunteers who rescue the snake, commonly called as sarpamitra, and release it into its natural habitat. Means instead of killing that snake, we can call Sarpamitra. Then this Sarpamitra are catching the snake and they are sending in the natural habitat. Now, remedial measures for snake bite. Giving emotional support to the victim means if any person is there, we can give emotional support. Washing the wound with water. So, wherever that snake has bite, that part we have to wash with the water. Tying a tight cloth above the wound so that the poison does not reach the vital organs. So if that snake bite to leg, then above that part, wherever snake bite, above that part you have to tie that cloth so that if that poison is there due to snake bite, that poison will not spread other parts of the body. Seeking medical help immediately and giving anti-venom to the victim. So you can take medical help and you can give anti-venom to the victim. Means anti-poison to the victim. Now, fifth type of remedial measure is dog bite. The dog bite can be dangerous if the dog is not vaccinated by anti-rabies vaccine. Dog has getting disease rabies, and for prevention of that disease, we are vaccinating to dog with the help of anti-rabies vaccine. Hence, immediate care and medical help should be given to the victim as rabies is 100% fatal. Means due to rabies disease, it is causing death also. Remedial measures for dog bite. Wound should be first cleaned and then washed with potassium permanganate solution. Wound should be covered with clean and dry cloth. So, potassium permanganate is one of the solution. And with the help of that solution, we can wash the wound. Taking help from a doctor, victim should be given anti-rabies vaccine and care of his or her wound should be taken. So, if in case of dog bite, we can give anti-rabies vaccine to patient also and we can take care of that patient's wound. Thank you.